six, a helping hand with your land.
This is Eddie here with Messick Service. Today we've got a BX that has transmission issues. We're gonna let you peek inside, take a look at what happens inside a transmission. This video is by no means instructional. It's just to give you a point of view and take a peek inside a transmission and let you see what's going on inside. So as you can see, we've already got the transmission up on a stand. We've gone ahead, we've pulled the hydrostatic pump and motor out, pulled the top cover off the transmission. We're gonna go down and stand up here and let you guys look down inside. So as you can see, we've got the transmission top cover off, standing up, looking down inside. So main input shaft, this is what's going to transfer the power from the engine into the transmission. Four-wheel drive, which we have in neutral right now. So rear PTO, front PTO. So on your input shaft, these gears right here, this is where your pump would ride, spinning this shaft. This shaft next to it, your main PTO shaft, is where your motor would be, spinning the PTO. So we've now taken and stuck the rotating group of the hydraulic pump and motor, set them down on the shaft so you can see. As this pump goes around, it goes over what we call a swash plate, which has an angle on it. It's curved. As this pump turns over this, it causes these pumps to actually pump. These pistons move in and down the pump. This is controlled. The swash plate on how this angle is set is controlled by a lever that comes out through here. So on this unit, as you push the lever forward, it will cause it to go one direction. As you push the lever backwards, it'll cause it to go another direction, causing you to go forward or reverse. This pumping action from this pump is what creates the pressure to make this motor spin. This motor uses that pressure in order to cause it to spin, and depending upon whether you're going forward or reverse would depend upon if your motor went forward and reverse. So we'll make this go around. This is in low range right now. We'll then move the range selector down, engage the other gear. This will put us in high range. Much easier for me to turn. Tractor will go much faster. So now we have four-wheel drive. This is in neutral right now. We can shift that into four-wheel drive. At that point, when we spin our axles, four-wheel drive shaft would spin, so your front wheels would also engage for traction. On this side of the transmission is where the PTO takes place. Front PTO, all of our gears are spinning. Rear PTO, I can spin this, but you can't see anything. The clutches and everything are all down inside. But this is, would be, spinning this makes your rear PTO spin. When it's engaged, your front PTO would spin off of this shaft. So now we're gonna pull out a handful of these gears and allow you to look down inside and see what happens below this level. So we've gone and pulled out all those gears on the top. We're now looking down in at the differential. You can see as we turn the shaft, the differential goes around. We're now gonna lock in the diff lock. You can see that diff lock move. Basically, that just makes both axles lock up. They cannot turn independent. They turn together now. So here we have the four-wheel drive shaft. Slides in and out. Bearings on this shaft, made in Japan. The gear slides on the shaft. If you were to look at the gear on the edges, you'll see normal wear marks from this being shifted into four-wheel drive. All of those little particles that wear off are picked up by your filter. That's why it's important to change your filter on a scheduled basis. Hope you enjoyed our teardown of this transmission. If there's anything we can do to help you with equipment like this one, we service all of Kubota's line here. Give us a call, 1-800-222-3373. Stop by our website, mestix.com.